I really should make an effort to play this more often. Because here's what happens. I play it, and there's like a bit of a period where I have to relearn it. And then I relearn it. I make some progression, and then I don't play it again for a while. And then I have to relearn it again. But I guess this game has kind of become like, I wouldn't say a plan B, but just between other games that I play it. Do I have... I don't think I can afford anything. That would be... Why? Oh, okay. That's passive. Oh, 100 gold off. Alright, fine. Can't buy it. I reckon just go. I think we're up to door number 5, if I'm remembering correctly. I have to remember. Hold on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hey, I remembered. Okay, so we're looking for 1, 2, 3, 4. Wait, is it Poison Lake? I guess I'm trying to figure out where to go after Sun Tower. Because Sun Tower was 4. No, Sun Tower was 5. Hang on. But I did Sun Tower. I'm fairly certain that this is what I did. No, I'm wrong. This is next. Okay. Oh, this is gonna be problematic. This is probably the worst passive I could have gotten right now for this. Yeah, this is not going to be fun. Oh! Can I just reroll the character? This is just going to suck. Like, this passive just blows for this. Okay. No, see, yeah, this is what I was up to. I guess just deal with it. Get whatever we can out of it. We maybe got some money. I'm not gonna expect to get very far with this. I think probably the reason I picked this, knowing that it's bad, is just there was probably a gold bonus on it, so. I can't see ahead of me. I don't know what this is. Okay. It looks like a big enough... Nope. Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay. No, there's something else. Oh, dude. This. How am I gonna do this? Like, this is... Okay, I'm gonna have to try. Like... This is beyond annoying. No, no, I can't do this. Not with this passive, like... I think I'm just gonna have to... go around and just murder stuff and just get money. And yeah, that'll be this initial run. There's no way I'm getting anything done. Not with this. Okay. Oh, okay. But again, here's another. Yep, this is another, I can't see what's going on, so I can't progress. So I guess I don't really have a choice, do I? There's both ways I have to deal with something, so I guess it may as well be this one. I don't care, like, at this point, just die. Yeah. Not a whole lot I could do about that one, that was just annoying. That seems good. Health regenerates, but you lose max HP when you know. Crippling intellect. I guess we'll find out what this is. I'm gonna buy the sanguine cape. Maybe now I have a chance. Now that I can see what's going on. This is much better. Shit. Why is this doing so much damage? What is crippling intellect? Is this like a really bad thing? 50% health and weapon damage, but mana. Okay. So, you know, Vampire Survivors, I wasn't having much luck, and I'm playing another roguelike, and it's the same thing. It's. Just one of these days, huh? Everything is old-timey. That doesn't seem too bad for a 25% gold bonus. Alright, I'll do this. Yeah, I can deal with this filter. I think. I'll try. Thank you. semi-normal character. What's this? You might be stronger than the S2R is, but you have something they don't, another chance. Is this... Okay, no, it's actually something. This is just lore, right? Yeah, I mean... Oh no, I got this ability. That, it's a good amount of damage, but it's a double-edged sword, so if I'm near it, it hurts. At least this run is going somewhere. Ah, okay. Ah, damn it, I pressed the wrong button. Still getting used to this again. All right, that's this. Nerdy glasses. Yeah, no, thank you. This one. Remove all visual ailments. Ah-ha-ha! Nice. All right, that's good. Now it's just the audio that's weird. Ow. Okay. Let's not mess with that. Getting a little desperate here. I'm gonna try and go up higher. Oh, jeez, that was close. fault. Oh, it's a fire one. I mean, if nothing else, decent amount of money. Oh. Okay. Could have been worse. Wait, no, this is nothing. No jumping. No, thank you. Nah. Oh, crap, I can't dash past it. Okay. I mean... Valkyrie reflects. Just looking at what else I can do. Increases health gain from health drops. It's probably not a bad idea. I'm gonna do that. Why doesn't it? Yeah. Doesn't reset it. Okay. There's a question mark in the middle here. What is that? I'm kind of surprised I did that without taking damage. It is a battle challenge, which I've never really done because they just tend to screw up your run. Okay, here's the problem. Getting here was one thing, getting back is another. Okay, I mean... This is quite the climb. I guess I should duck into each of these rooms to see what they have. While below 50 health, deal 20% more. Spell, what is this? Increases mana pool by 50. It's probably a good call. And damage as well, so. I kind of wish you could aim with mages, but to my knowledge, it's just shooting in a straight line. Ooh, chef. I want a chef. Complete array of ailments. Applies freeze, burn, spore burst. Yeah, this is a good one. I think I got a good character. At least from a damage perspective. I don't know, I find it a little clunky that it's the same as dash. Oh, dick. Hopefully I'll find more food. Really? This is tough. There's so many things that are too far away. Oh, okay. Yeah, there we go, food. Okay. Nice. It's just another one of these. Glowing Ember, what sounds reasonable. Gain 100 mana, mana can overcharge. Ooh. Probably this one. Cause then this ability can get spammed. Oh, crap. I'm doing it. Yeah, this is good. This is a good build. I think I'm fine. Like I would much rather not lose health than whatever it is those things have to give me, honestly. Dude, this is so clunky. I hate it. Having it be the same as the bottom dash button. Okay. I can go heal, though. Okay, we have the throne room, so what I'm gonna do, I'm going to a previous area and I'm gonna heal up to give this the best chance I can have of beating it. Let me use this. It makes sense. We just need to find 3 pieces of food. Oh, I get food from mana as well. Okay. So either will work. Shouldn't take long to acquire this. Oh, yeah, no, we don't want to be here. That's next. Huh. Yeah. Let's do that. I'm gonna get all that health back anyway when I go through the boss door. Nice, got the food. Okay, one more. I'm almost certain if I go through that door, because I got mana for going through that door, it counts, and it replenishes my food anyway, but I don't want to risk it. The heavy stone bargain. The sky is your flag and the foe is your floor. They sound really ominous. I don't wanna do it and ruin what I have. This is good. There we go. All right, let's get out of here. Convenient. Holy crap. This is not what I was expecting. Okay. Oh. Oh, this is horrible. I can't even use this. I can't even... What the heck is this fight? Dude, okay. That, yeah, that... That's a fight, alright. So my strategy did not work. I did get a bunch of gold, so that's fine. I'm just thinking. Got weapon damage. I haven't done that in a while. That was tough. I don't get why it can't just be like this, an upgraded version of Kick. Sometimes it's so clunky. Like, I get that it's Void Dash, but yeah, I don't know. Could have made a Void Kick Because if you're off by even a little bit, you just dash into something you don't want to. I keep going to kick it. Alright, just forget it. I'm gonna take more damage than what it's worth. So, is there nothing I can do about those balls that chase me? Those eyeballs shoot it, and it doesn't seem like there's anything I can do. I think this run's gone already. Leaving that for the time being. Assassins. I may as well start unlocking some of these new classes. I'm hoping this will work because the shield might be able to protect me from those balls. Those energy balls. Okay. Oh yeah, I've got super jump. That's kind of useful, actually. I mean, for this, it's definitely useful. Yeah, I'm not sure how this is gonna go. Wait, what? Oh, I see, that's what the passive is. Like actual Mario. Losing health, I'm good. This is nice though, being able to just jump and kind of bypass stuff. This jumping thing is really useful here. Uh oh, I messed up. Oh, fixed it. I don't like that ability. It has to hit a wall. I'm gonna heal. I'm not gonna risk it. I'd rather live. This character's already got a lot of health anyway. Yep, this is why I hate this. I don't know why that it's a dash. Have not found health. I Dude, those balls are so obnoxious, and the fact that the boss is gonna shoot three of them. I am good. Okay, I found it. All right, same thing as before. I'm really hoping the shield will carry me through this. Okay, that is a heal. Let me leave it for the time being. Because if I can recover my health. Still leave that. And I can increase my max health. At least that's what I'm thinking. Spells cast all at max HP. That is the most useless one ever. When is anyone on max HP? Attacks apply mana leech. Interesting. Interesting. The thing about the spell is, well, spells for this fight. Like, I'm not sure I can even use them based on how it went the first time. Yeah, okay, so, like, that is a pretty good combo. For a boss, like, it's gonna be draining. That's really decent. I'm good. I'm not interested in that chest. I just want health. Shit. Okay, it's not that much of a health loss. This passive is funny. I think I can do it. I think I might actually be able to. Okay, now I can. Now I definitely can. Increase my health. I'll walk backwards and go get it. Doesn't matter, they're both pretty close. I know it's set me back, but I can recover it. Excuse me. I don't think this is a good one to try and get health on, but I just wanted to see these barrels if they would give anything. This one might be. Still part of this map left to go, so. It's a weapon. First strike. Skill crits high health enemies. Second strike skill crits low health enemies. It's I'd rather stick to what I have. I don't wanna muddy it up. Good. Excellent. Alright, we're good. Yeah, that's it. That's still gonna provide me with full health, but doesn't matter. I'm not looking forward to this. This seems a bit insanely tricky. Already. is just like a really annoying bullet hell. I think that character probably has the best chance. What is this? A cloak that avoids all damage, recharges on hitting enemies. Your mana has infinite over. No, thanks. Yeah, I mean, I think this is a case of just grind and eventually I'll be able to beat it. Do that. Okay. I already missed the high jump. No, that didn't work. Okay. We don't have a weapon spin. Oh, that's interesting. This is an interesting synergy. The more I hit, the more fire's gonna be up. It's like, as long as I keep hitting, I can keep my fire up. Gonna try and get to the end, honestly. Excuse me. Dashing leaves a poison cloud behind. Alright, let's just see what this is for the sake of seeing it. Randomize your weapon. Uh-oh. Oh, shit. Okay, we have changed. We are now a very tanky assassin. I mean, I wanted to try assassin, that's cool. Oh, that's cool. It helped quite a bit. Oh, God. Okay, I still got it. I mean, that seemed cool, it's just... Casting your talent or spell will fire one Starbolt. Chronic Fatigue Syndrome, alright. Well, it's a negative thing, so... There's nothing I can buy. All spells have a cooldown. But that was already the case, I guess, with the talent. So, whatever. That's fine. Unless it makes it extra bad, which... Okay. Oh no, yeah, this is worse. It's 12 hits now. Nah, this is a garbage run. Effectively taking away this character's like purpose. Just makes it so worse to play. Okay, hang on. I'll still try it just to get used to that fight more, but having shield not up, I don't know. This looks surprisingly smooth. You haven't seen me play this before? It's pretty fun. It can be a bit on the tricky side. It's a roguelike Castlevania type game, but the way it works is like when you die, you pick an heir and they get passives or traits, I guess. And you kind of have to deal with it. Some of them are positive, some of them are negative. This one is negative. I don't think I'm gonna get very far. Yeah. Okay. I don't think an archer's gonna do well against that boss at all. I'll try, but I just doubt that this is gonna work. Okay. Can't buy anything. Alright, move on. This boss is gonna take a while. I think the Lancer probably has the best chance just because it has something that can deal with those balls of energy that for some reason you can't do anything about. It's just, oh, three of them are gonna chase you in a very small room where you have no floor. Yeah, my confidence is not high on this one. Of all the bosses I've seen so far, this one just seems to be just annoying by design. Do it with the analog stick. There we go. Maybe I should play with analog stick. I was using D-pad. D-pad understandably locks it. I mean, that's, I guess that's a neat feature. If you want to lock to 45 degree angles, you can. This is bullshit. I chose poorly. Nah. I tried to kick off it. Sometimes you get a room that's just... a clown. 30% less health, but you can kick off terrain. No. You die in one hit. No. Puritan. Compulsive gambling. I guess this one's like the lesser of evils. I'm not gonna do well this run just because of the 30% hit on health. You can spin kick off terrain, so what? Oh yeah. I mean, that might be useful. It's just... we'll see how it goes. That's not a lot of health. I wanna... oh, right, I can just do that. I can just spin kick off walls. Yeah, okay. Yeah, that, I mean, don't get me wrong, that's useful. Worth 30% of your health useful? Don't think so. I feel like if I'm not confident, I should just try and get as much as I can out of the run from a money perspective. Just ignoring you, bye. I don't want to have to deal with those rooms. Those rooms, they're just too much of a gamble. They just stack enemies and you end up ruining your run, like 90% of the time. I think that's my one complaint about this game is like the challenge rooms. Understandably, are phrased correctly as a challenge, but like, it's to the point where, for me, I just won't do them 90% of the time. Because they will just ruin your run. I should have abandoned this room. I guess I got a blueprint for it. Sanguine Trinket. Hey, another part of the Sanguine set. Alright, cool. I might buy that. Okay. I don't like that they decided to make that mechanic around dash instead of down kick. Like, it's weird. And if you miss by it, ever so slightly, the smallest amount, then you just do a dash and then you just die. No immunity window, no thank you. Yeah, maybe. Okay. Oh, I need to increase my equip allowance. Okay, that's fine. Next run, we'll do that. The whites. I think, honestly, the only class I'll be able to get through this is the Lancer. Frustrates me so much when that happens. Holy crap. Alright. I'm just gonna do this right away. I know. The heavy gamble, but I'm taking the heavy gamble. See. Dude, what is this? This thing. Like, you can't get rid of it unless you kill the enemy. And the boss does that. That's the part that I just cannot get over. Guy has like a vertical bomb man with a gun too. It's the passive ability. So you get like, you get a weapon, you get a talent, and then you get a spell. So the talent is the TNT. But you can of course swap them out. Like during runs you can run into alternative talents you can use. I don't mind this class. This class is pretty good. Once you get used to the reloading aspect of it, it's pretty fun. What a, this is a cursed room. I should have left it. Don't get hit, destroy all targets. Nah. What? What am I supposed to do here? Whatever. I'm leaving it. Oh, you've got to be kidding. This is all a dead end. Ah, shit. Okay. Did I at least make money? Not really. I might try this class. I haven't done much with it, so let's just see. Increase max weight capacity, that's what we want. There we go. monsters that can pick sanguine. Just need to get the sanguine weapon, which is how much? 1600. Okay, nearly. I like that ability because poison. Poison's really good. Okay, let's see how we do. First time playing this class properly. I can't believe there's nothing you can do about this ball of energy. Like, you just have to run it into something. I mean, for us little... I'm not complaining about it in the sense of the little enemy. It's the boss. The fact that the boss does that in such an enclosed... You'll see when I get up to it. And tell me if it's my imagination or if it's, like, kind of bullshit. Oh, you can't even run into a wall and get rid of it. What? I down kicked. Okay, I mean, at least this passive seems to... What is that? It seems to generate quite a bit of food, which is good. Or maybe it's a class, I don't know, but... I forget that I'm... regenning mana on the hit. Every unique relic increases your damage. 20% bonus with a status effect. Yes! That is a good synergy. I lost a bit of max health, but it's worth it because... I'll just leave that. That's too much of a gamble. I wonder if mana drain counts. What is... Why am I getting these cursed rooms? Oh my god, fuck that. Yeah, cool. So I'm just dead now, am I? Lucky. I've gotten screwed by the map. I think I just need to ignore and just go. I'm not interested in that. Spin kick supply armor break. Defeating enemies, yeah, but I can't pick this up because if I do, it'll reduce my health. But I don't have enough resolve. But I've made it to the top of the tower. So that's something. Alright, I'm gonna go back. Heal. And we'll try and fight this thing. Wait, do I need to even do... I think I don't need to do that, but... Just in case I do, let's just... Because I could always find another health increase thing, and that would counterbalance the health I lost. I've already healed enough. Bashing. Okay, it's the same thing, but like, yeah, I don't have enough resolve to do it. Yeah, so it's a weapon first. I don't even know what this does. I might try it. Oh no, it's a dash. I'm screwed. This just ruined the run. Why does it dash? Why does it dash? Like, that just completely removes any form of usability this might have. I'm just gonna be taking damage here. I grabbed it because I was like, okay, maybe this is cool, but this is so pointless. That's it, I'm screwed. If it gave you iframes, that'd be cool. Because then you could strategically use it, but this is just objectively worse in every regard. Like, in a game where positioning is important, really? Alright, I guess... roll with that, but I'm gonna lose. Yeah. I'm just gonna keep taking damage because this weapon forces me to dash. And these are the There's no way any other class other than the Lancer can do this fight. There's too many projectiles, and three of them follow you around the room. Guess go this one. I'm gonna purchase the other part of the Sanguine set. I just need to increase the allowance. But that's fine, we can do that later. I just wanted to get everything to the Sanguine baseline, which I'm pretty much there. The only thing I can think of is, like, maybe certain bosses try to force you to use certain classes, so then everything gets equal playtime, but I don't know. Okay, Because that is like an extreme bullet hell, and there's nothing wrong with it, but then there's the small room and the platforming aspect of it. It's like you really don't have much space to move. And the bullets follow you, like, it's kind of fucked. Helped, yep. Okay. I'm just gonna go in here quickly. Doing this right away. I'm just taking the hit. I'm going to assume I'm gonna fix it. I've gone the wrong way. I have to keep climbing. What? Oh, sickle. Damn it. Yeah, that run didn't get me anything. Okay. I did get the Lancer, but it's like a passive where you take more damage. But it has Life Leech, which I guess maybe it'll pair up well with the Lancer. We'll see. Ugh. This might be the first time I play this and not be able to make progress. Usually every time I play this, I'll beat a boss, but this one's a tall order. I'm about to lose. Okay, there is an advantage to that. If I can keep stabbing, sure. The only thing is I take a lot of damage. Yeah, I don't think this is gonna work. If they're doing that amount of damage to me, the boss is just gonna, like, one-shot me. How much did I make? 2,000. Can I just get a normal lancer? Just one that doesn't have anything, really. Clumsy like a bull in a china shop. I guess let's try that one. Doesn't seem like that bad of a passive. Hopefully that weight capacity allows me to equip. Not yet. Okay. I think once I equip that weapon, it's gonna make a difference. Oh yeah, right. Everything will just break instantly. Oh, this is going backwards. Nice. Good use. Oh shit, I didn't see that. This passive's great, but it's ultimately useless against the boss. Go. Okay, I'm gonna have one more try and then we're gonna play some Animal Crossing because I've been wanting to play that. So, let's hope this goes well. Destroys large projectiles. No. Yeah, let's do this. I don't know. I don't think this is gonna work. Alright, let's go. I haven't had much luck with this area tonight. I think this is just gonna be purely a matter of eventually I'll have upgraded my characters enough that they will be able to withstand this. You know what? No. I feel like I haven't found much food either. Okay. Nope, I'm just ignoring this room. Oh, what? I did the down thing. No, it's too risky. Halt to channel and summon crows. Crows attack nearby energy, but will ignore cursed projectiles. Interesting. I think I've chosen poorly though. Because the problem with this weapon is that boss is not going to let me charge it. For clearing rooms, this is going to be great. Like, I almost feel like taking this run and just farming with it. Because that's honestly probably the best thing I can do with it. But for the boss, there's just no way I'll be able to win with this. It's too much of a wind-up, and that boss does not give you any room. Is it just, like, every single one of those weapons that just... they're not worth using? It almost seems like that. Everyone I've come across so far, they just... they look cool, but in terms of usability... it's like, you're kind of just screwed in a boss fight. That's... I haven't seen a single one of these that... isn't that. Oh, okay. Yeah. Pretty much the moment I got that weapon, I was boned. Okay, let's pick an air. Give me a normal Lancer. Okay, white class. You know what, I'm just gonna do one more run, because that one was cut short. Hey, Sanguine. That's it. Complete Sanguine set. Alright, now I'm curious how this goes. That already seems better. What is that? I've really grown to dislike this area, honestly. Between the kick mechanic being like a dash, instead of just using kick. Oh, this isn't even the right way. This area just seems to be suffering. Okay, I guess I have to go around. Shouldn't have gone for that. I just wanted to get higher. Blessing. Applies poison. I'm good. I think I'll stick to what I have. Okay, lucky. What is this? I have to collide with it. Just... as long as I get to the throne room, I'll be happy. Nope. I'm just gonna climb. That seems too tedious. And yet I might not have a choice. Dude. Some of these obstacles, oh my god. Okay. Your weapon and talent is randomized. Fabled pizza, return to user. Apparently I got a weapon. Well, for 25% gold, getting random stuff, why not? Although... okay, I want to find out what Hero Complex is. Alright, but I am leaving it here. This area is gonna be tough. I might have to focus some runs on just acquiring money and nothing else. But that boss, I'm pretty certain the other way I'm gonna get through it is to get a Lancer. Just every single Lancer I got, except the first one, had some weird thing downside to it, so I couldn't pick it. So, yeah. Alright. We're gonna take a small intermission, and I'm gonna come back and do some Animal Crossing for the rest of the evening. So, if you're here for Rogue Legacy 2, thanks for tuning in, or if you're watching this later on YouTube, as always, thanks for clicking. Alright, bye YouTube.